they're competing right now. You know, in the scrimmage, we kind of had the good, the bad, and the ugly. I think the good was that we were on third down. Both groups were 60%, and that's a positive because we always talk about the money downs. We talked about first down efficiency, and we were pretty good on first down efficiency. I thought their effort and their physicality was really good. The bad, we had two pre-snap penalties, which was awful, and it was the first and third play. One by an offensive lineman, the other one by our receivers, and that was ridiculous, especially when we just got them talking about it. You know? And the ugly was two interceptions, a drop ball in a critical situation. We had a lot of missed opportunities in the pass game. But that all being said, it's encouraging because we've got a chance to, I think, be really good. So we got to get that cleaned up between now and Saturday, and then Saturday when it's a full live tackle, we've got to be able to execute and fix all that stuff.
How are the quarterbacks Saturday?
Good, bad, and ugly. Yeah. It was the first scrimmage, just how we expected. You know, I liked them both, though. We made some mistakes, and nobody panicked. We actually recovered after those first two penalties. We actually recovered and came back and got a first down, which is hard to do. So, they're going to learn, and I think when you have two guys that are in the mix of three guys that are in the mix of battling and they haven't had a lot of playing experience, that's what the spring's for.
How strange is the dynamic to have so many guys back that have played in your system and done all this, and then to the main signal caller to sort of be an unknown?
Yeah, and that's good. I think that's good and bad. You know, one, we can get the guys in the right place, hopefully most of the time for them. You know, and I think that's important. So I think it's really going to benefit us that they know what they're doing. And we're not, you know what, and we're kind of done with the install for a little bit now. You know, we've got enough in right now where we can go into a game easy with what we got in there. We need to get great at what we're doing right now. So we've kind of pulled back and just said, let's get great at fundamentals and technique in spring and get better that way.
Today the first day you were outside?
Yes, first of seven.
How necessary was that? Stoops has talked about it's just there's stuff you can't do in the indoor. Maybe.
Yes, it's huge. The room that you have, what you get, and you know, just the energy. I mean, you could see it this morning when I got out there. It's just good to get some fresh air and, you know, get off that turf, and there's not a lot of room, you know. You get under the lights this morning, and it just gives you new energy.
Have any of those second-year receivers other than Lynn stepped up this spring and impressed you a little?
Yeah, I think Josh and Epps, I think Cleveland, all of them are showing up right now. You can just see the confidence in all four of those guys. You know, they're different. You know, they're competing at a higher level. They're not making the same mistakes that they made. And just, I think, mostly the confidence.
And when you get so many people back at all the positions except quarterback, does that impact what you're looking at? And say, maybe we don't have to have a running quarterback who may be better at that when you've got a good running game. Maybe you have receivers who can go really deep. You need the quarterback with a stronger arm. How does all that play when you're trying to figure out who your quarterback should be at the end of the game?
Well, we have both. The good part about us is that all of our run game and everything we do read it. You know, there's going to be an opportunity. Doesn't matter who our quarterback is, that we're going to have an opportunity to run the ball. We've got to keep the defense even with us. You know, we got to try to equalize it, if you will. So. And the way you do that is with the run-pass options, and again, it's a run-pass option, so he's got a chance to run it too. It's not always a throw.
Right.
So, you know, both of them can do that. Doesn't matter who you are. I mean, both of them need to be able to throw deep. So we're going to continue with our vertical schemes and our concepts and try to be explosive. One of the things I said at the beginning of the spring is that we need to be a more explosive football team. And we were close with the twos. We were 1 of 8, and that's where we want to be. And we were 1 of 10 with the ones. So we were pretty close in this first one.
But anything about spring practices that you like more than fall practices, even though you don't have the reward of a game at the end of the week?
Yeah, we don't have to win this week. It's awesome. It's awesome just to be able to teach and go out and just not have that, pressure, just, you know, that grind. You know, now you can have fun, and these young guys that are really learning, it's a different atmosphere. I enjoy it. You know, as a play caller, you can call some things and do some stuff that, you know, if it doesn't work, then you find out what your enemy is, and And, you know, I think you'd learn from that, you know. And then we can fix it now, better now than on 3rd and 5 in a big play, you know, in the fall.
How much is the health situation at tight end with what you've been able to do this spring, or has it?
You know, we've got to give tight end sets to our defense. That's huge, because you got to give them the power run game. But, you know, Vince is doing a great job coaching them up, and they're doing a great job trying to make it work. So, you know, we're doing our best.
Making all the work, obviously, we've got that conference line. It's just being very effective and efficient. But really, it is.
I think that group right now is doing a great job. I think we've got more depth this year right now. We're right where we need to be. And, like I've said before, and I've talked about our offensive line, I think our offensive line is smart. They understand the game, and they don't make a lot of mental errors. You know, that's a tribute to Coach Slarman and how he coaches. But we're able to do the things we do because of those guys up front.